Well, hi everyone, Steve Patterson here from Photoshop Essentials. In this video, I'll show you how to create a mirror image effect with Photoshop. This is an update to my original mirror image video from a couple of years ago, and since then, Photoshop has seen a few changes. So this time, I've come up with a new way to create the effect, one that's faster, easier, and works with any recent version of Photoshop. I'm using Photoshop CC 2020, but any version will work. If you like these videos, be sure to subscribe, and let's get started. So here's the image I'll be using. I downloaded this one from Adobe Stock. Now, before we mirror the image, let's make a copy of our Photoshop document, and that way we won't accidentally save the mirrored version over the original. Go up to the Image menu in the menu bar and choose Duplicate. Then in the Duplicate Image dialog box, name the copy Mirror and click OK. And if we look at the document tabs, we see that we're now working on a copy of the image named Mirror. You can close the original document by clicking the small X in its tab. Next, select the Crop tool from the toolbar. And in the Options bar, make sure the Aspect Ratio is set to Ratio. This will let us freely adjust the sides of the cropping border. Now, depending on which direction your image needs to flip, click on the left or right side of the cropping border and drag it over to the spot where the image will be mirrored. In my case, I want to flip the image from left to right using the woman's hair as the mirror point. So I'll drag the right side of the cropping border to that location. I also don't need all of that empty space on the left side of the image, so to crop some of it away, I'll drag the left side of the cropping border inward. Before you crop the image, go up to the Options bar and make sure Delete Cropped Pixels is checked. And then, still in the Options bar, click the check mark to crop the image. In the Layers panel, we see the image on the background layer. Make a copy of the background layer by dragging it down onto the Add New Layer icon. The copy appears above the original. Then go up to the Edit menu and choose Free Transform. The Free Transform box and handles appear around the image. And in the center of the Transform box is a target icon known as the reference point. This point marks the center of the transformation. If you're using a newer version of Photoshop and the reference point is missing, go up to the Options bar and click inside the Toggle Reference Point checkbox. Then click on the reference point and drag it onto the handle on the side where the image will flip. Since my image is going to flip from left to right, I'll drag the reference point onto the right side handle. Then with the Free Transform command still active, right-click on a Windows PC or Control-click on a Mac anywhere inside the image and choose Flip Horizontal from the menu. It won't look like the image has flipped. Instead, the Free Transform box will move into the pasteboard area beside the image. Accept it and close Free Transform by clicking the check mark in the Options bar. If the cropping border is still visible around your image, it's because the Crop tool is still active. Click on a different tool in the toolbar to remove it. I'll click the Rectangular Marquee tool. So at this point, we've created the mirrored version of the image, but we can't see it because the mirrored half is sitting in the pasteboard area off to the side. We need a way to view the entire Photoshop canvas, and we can view it by going up to the Image menu in the menu bar and choosing Reveal All. And just like that, we have our mirror image effect. And there we have it! That's how easy it is to mirror an image with Photoshop. As always, I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, don't forget to like it, share it, and subscribe to my channel. Visit my website, PhotoshopEssentials.com, where you'll find hundreds of Photoshop tutorials. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time. I'm Steve Patterson from PhotoshopEssentials.com.